Morning, everybody. I am Mozal Boussaidi from Suhar Hospital. Today, I will present to you about the feedback about the genetic counseling training for the first module, which was about Down syndrome. The activities for Down syndrome module: collecting the statistics about Down syndrome notification process and follow-up protocol, the lab visit about chromosomal karyotyping process, also attending the pediatric, ophthalmic, ENT, gastrointestinal, and cardiologic, plus antenatal clinic to observe Down syndrome surface, visiting Al-Wafa Social Center and health education program. First, I will mention that Ahmed Al-Gabri, the chairman for Down syndrome parent support group, said that about 1.428 children were registered as being affected by Down syndrome at the Ministry of Health from 2005-2010. But several cases went unidentified due to lack of awareness or were brushed under the carpet, as it is considered to be a taboo subject in the country. This one, the statistics of Down syndrome in North Patna, I collected from the DG. In 2008, it was 9 cases, 2009 was 7 cases, 2010 was 7. The highest number was in 2012, 2014, it was 6, and in 2015, there was some doubt. In DG office, they give me only one number, but when I was checking the register in SCABU, I found about 5 cases. So that means the there is some mistake in the statistics. Also, for 2014, from the DG office, they give me only 6 cases in North Batna. But in SCABU, itself was 6 cases, but I couldn't add. So, this statistics, it is accurate or not? The number of babies born in this condition is each year increasing. The exact number of children with Down syndrome, so it is unknown. Due to poor compliance of physicians and nurses to fill the congenital form, also the efficacy of congenital anomaly form notification form, because this form just we will fill suspected cases, not before the, it is only before the result. So only suspected cases, maybe we'll collect chromosomal study and it will be negative. Also, the statistical register was not available in the hospital. Only we have one register in SCABU, and for the chromosomal study only. So without statistics, we cannot know the extent of the Down syndrome children. We need the statistics to plan for their health, service, education, employment, and even funding. So what I have, I did my plan to improve the statistics in Suhar Hospital. In Monday, the lab, they will collect chromosomal study and they will send to Royal Hospital. So each Monday, I will go to the lab and I will take all the cases that they would send, and I will follow up the result by myself. I make one registered with me, like this one, big one. And each the result will take 3 to 4 weeks, so I will document the finding, and monthly I will do the statistics. So it will be, for the hospital, it will be accurate. But about the other hospital, because in North Batna we have Saham Hospital, Wadi Hibi Hospital, many hospitals, and they are not doing. I called the DG and I told them to inform their doctors and nurses to follow the congenital abnormality form. And also from our side, I informed the consultant and pediatrician to fill this one. About the Omani protocol for Down syndrome, I got this protocol guideline for medical management of children and young people with Down syndrome. I got only the first edition, it was 2012, but it was reviewed and updated. There is one 2015, but I couldn't get it. The objective of the Omani guideline provide a care pathway for the people with Down syndrome and their family, describe the appropriate management for the children with Down syndrome according to the healthcare system available in Oman. In our hospital, still they are not using this guideline. I couldn't also distribute because there is a new one. I am searching just for a new one and I will distribute to them. About the activity in the clinic, I went to antenatal clinic to check the surface available there. We have only NT scan, which are done at 11 to 14 weeks. It measures the fluid filled space at the base of the baby neck. If the measurement of more than 6 mm, it indicates baby with Down syndrome. According to the consultant, it can be considered as accurate 70% with, if it is accompanied with a blood investigation like alpha fetoprotein, but it is not available with us. If they noted there's abnormality in NT scan and there's some congenital anomaly and some heart defect, they will refer the cases for amniocentesis to Royal Hospital for further investigation to know the abnormality exactly. About the Al-Wafa Social Center, I visit for 2 days. There is many services and programs they have, like Bortek program. They will accept the children from age 0 to 3 years. In that stage, they will follow the development of the children. Also, they will do from 2 to 3 years the training for the toilet. And also, there's early intervention program from 3 to 6 years, and pre-academic and academic program. This one, early intervention program, it will be after till 6 years. After 6 years, they will go, they will take them to the governmental school, integration with normal school. But if the children, they will not accept there, like there will not be trained for the toilet or some other problem, they will return back to the center, so they will be in pre-academic and academic program till age of 12 years. After age of 12 years, they will go to occupational therapy. Also, they have other services like physiotherapy and speech therapy, recreational activity. About the Down syndrome service at the ophthalmology clinic, I visit Suhar Health Center. I don't get any case that day, and according to the doctor, she is receiving less cases for Down syndrome with ophthalmic problem, just only follow up for the school at age 5 years. So the most problem, according to her, refractory error, strabismus, nystagmus, and cataract. And in T clinic, the most cases, otitis media with effusion, and also deafness. And about the cardio clinic, the cases which I got, ventricular septal defect and BDA, beta ductus arteriosus. Also, I got mitral valve prolapse, but there is other cases, which is TOF, tetralogy of Fallot, which include 4, PSD, pulmonary stenosis, right ventricular hypertrophy, and overriding of aorta, plus mitral valve regurgitation also will be seen in Down syndrome. There is no special follow-up for them in cardio clinic unless they will get some abnormality that they noted heart murmur with the baby. Before, there was like protocol, each 6 months of the egg, they will do echo for all Down syndrome, but now because overload in echo, and there is only 1 day for echo, so they will not do unless there be some problem with the baby. About the GI clinic, gastrointestinal clinic, the most cases will be seen like duodenal atresia, celiac disease, and perforated anus and esophageal atresia. The case which I see, her subarachnoid disease, the baby was egg is about 2 weeks, but they was unsure because the baby, he passed the stool within the first 2 days, so I was doubting. Because for this her subarachnoid disease, if the baby passing within the 24 hours, that means he's not having this condition. This means it is absent of the ganglion cell which control the rectal muscle to push. The endocrine clinic, there will be hypothyroidism. I saw one case about 12 years with hypothyroidism. She's in regular follow-up with electroxine medication, thyroxine. The health education program, it was I distribute educational pamphlet. I have a copy of it. Also individual health education at the bedside. I am going to visit the cases in pediatric surgical, pediatric medical, SCABU, BICU, any case I will note it, I will give individual health education, and I will answer their doubt about the service available for the Down syndrome. Also, I schedule presentation with cooperation with the Wafa Center in Suhar Hospital. It will be next month, 2016, in January. Also, they schedule for me 2 lectures. It will be in SCABU, one about Down syndrome, and other one, it will be about the most common chromosomal abnormality in unit and children. The major requirement was also HPLC process, high performance liquid chromatography. First, they will collect in this one red bottle, it will be around 1 to 2 mL. After that, they will send to the lab. This one we are calling Gridenum AUD machine, like that. After that, if there will be some doubt in the result, like A2, 3.1 to 3.3, they will repeat the sample. It will be this one, a new one, variant 2. They are using also just for checking. After that, it will be like this one, and the physician, they will interpret the one. And the result, the final result, it will be like this one. HPLC, it will use to detect if there is any thalassemia or sickle cell disease plus other variant, like S and F. The other chromosomal abnormality I saw during my rotation, trisomy 18, and which called Edwards syndrome, also trisomy 13 Patau syndrome. Also, I see one case, Middle East syndrome. They are calling Sangat-Sakati syndrome, according to the one who discovered it. This problem in Oman, it was in 1992, maybe they say the first case in SQH. There was one study also done in 1992. There will be the feature of this one, it will be intrauterine growth retardation at the birth, microcephaly, congenital hyperparathyroidism, which lead to hypocalcemia and can cause the convulsion. Plus, there will be some facial feature like long narrow face, deep set eyes, big nose, floppy and large ears, long bilaterium, they mean this area.
Philtrum.
Thin lips and microgynecia. They will have also mild to moderate intellectual defect. In Arabian, they have other name, I think, Kaffi syndrome, something like that. Also, I went to the hereditary blood blood disorder clinic. I saw thalassemia cases, blood sickle cell disease, G6BD deficiency, and spherocytosis. Thank you.
Well done.
I want to mention something, the second one.